In the late 60s, viewers of the Smothers Brothers Comedy Hour often heard the catchphrase, "Better living through chemistry." It was spoken by Leigh French, who, with a wink of an eye, was actually referring to drugs. But now a research study connected with Rockefeller University is pushing better acceptance of immigrants through chemistry. Welcome to Wait Till You Hear This. I'm Steve Eastman. First of all, I'd like to say I am not against immigrants, but I do believe we must have a vetting process to ensure we only take in honest folk who want to assimilate into our culture. And because we do not have unlimited resources, we can only take in so many immigrants at a time. Sweden is a perfect example of not following this common sense approach. It turns out there's a rape epidemic there in immigrant-dominated no-go zones that police have been unable or unwilling to enter. But that's enough background. Let's get to the main point. Researchers in the United States and Germany have published a study concluding that doping citizens with oxytocin, an estrogen-related hormone, would make them more accepting toward migrants, even more generous. It was edited by Bruce McEwen of Rockefeller University. Here's a quote: "Accommodating the large influx of migrants not only challenges the humanitarian capacities of European countries, but also requires their native populations to adjust to rapid growths in ethnic diversity, religious pluralism, and cultural differentiation. Resistance to this transition often goes along with xenophobic sentiment." Dictionary.com defines xenophobia as fear or hatred of foreigners, people from different cultures, or strangers. The politically correct definition focuses on hate, but I believe that's a modern interpretation. For example, take another phobia word, agoraphobia. That's the fear, not hatred, of crowds. Oxytocin has several nicknames: the love hormone, the hug hormone, and the cuddle chemical. The pituitary gland releases it during romantic times and at breastfeeding. The study actually used oxytocin nasal spray in what it calls xenophobic test subjects. Ready for another quote? "Our results imply that an OXT-enforced social norm adherence could be instrumental in motivating a more generalized acceptance toward ethnic diversity, religious pluralism, and cultural differentiation resulting from migration, by proposing that interventions to increase altruism are most effective when charitable social cues instill the notion that one's in-group shows strong affection for an out-group." Phew, what a mouthful. Since when is it government's business to try to control how we feel? I seem to remember, at least in the United States, it's the government's job to act on the will of the people. When an unlimited number of unvetted immigrants comes into a country, complete with no-go zones for police, people have a right to fear, or at least be concerned. And don't stick that xenophobic label on them. Fear and hatred are two different things. If all this sounds like science fiction, you're correct. 85 years ago, Aldous Huxley wrote about an oxytocin-like drug in Brave New World. These are his words: "By this time, the soma had begun to work. Eyes shone, cheeks were flushed. The inner light of universal benevolence broke out on every face in happy, friendly smiles." Yeah, that's what they're trying to pull off. This is Steve Eastman for Wait Till You Hear This.
Discover more stories like this one on our website, waittillyouhearthis.com.